Hello guys, in this video you're going to study the safety alarms and threat testing of incinerator. At first, let's carry out the function text of the limit switch. Open the cover of the charging door locker. Loosen the wind bolt of the door lock and turn off the charging door wheel from the furnace. Other times, the opening alarm will activate on control panel or incinerator. Close the charging door after carry off the function text or limit switch, and then secure the charging door by the lock. Stop the alarm and press the abnormal reset button. After carrying out the function test of the door locker, close the cover of the charging door. Now you can see how to test the flue gas high temperature alarm. Shift to E1 on exhaust temperature controller. After then, reduce the temperature set point below the current value. Gas OIE alarm activates on control panel after a few seconds. Flue gas high temperature alarm is set at 350 degrees centigrade. And then set the high temperature alarm to original set value 350 degrees centigrade. Okay, let's carry out the furnace high temperature alarm testing. To test the furnace high temperature alarm testing, shift to the E4 on furnace temperature controller. After then, reduce the high furnace temperature alarm set point and wait for a few seconds. Furnace overheat alarms will activate on control panel. Normally, high furnace temperature alarm is set at 1200 degrees centigrade. After then, set the alarm to the original value. Press the anomaly reset buttons to deactivate the alarm on the panel. The maker of this incinerator is Sunflames and the model is OSV-C100SAI. Okay, let's carry out the misfire alarm. To carry out the misfire alarm, loosen and remove the sockets of the flare sensors. Open valves, which are necessary for the burning of incinerator. open diesel one inlet bar to the main burner and diesel one inlet to the pilot burner. After that, ensure that all of the valve along the pipelines to the main burner is in open position. And then start running the accelerator and ensure that the full drive fan is running. After then, switch on the main burner and igniter. The firing occurs inside the furnace or accelerator. But misfire alarm will activate because we disconnect the socket of the flare sensor. Reconnect the socket to the flare sensor in proper position. Switch off the igniter, switch off the main burner, and stop running of the accelerator. Press the anomaly reset buttons to deactivate the alarm on the panel. Let's carry out the low body alarm testing. To test the low body alarms, we need to open the front cover of the control panel. Clear the latches over the body sensor. After that, pull out the body sensor from its base. Low body alarm will activate after clear the body sensor from the base. Fit the body sensors to its base and secure by the safety latches. Reset the low body alarm on the control panel and ensure that the alarm is deactivated. Now you can see the drive force alarm testing in two methods. First, start running the accelerator. The running indicator will light up on the control panel and full drive fan is running, supplying the L to the furnace. Press the trip buttons on the overload relay of the drive fan. The drive fan will stop immediately and drive force alarms activate on control panel. Accelerator safety alarm and trip testing should be carried out every 3 months interval. Press the reset button on the overload relay and ensure that the alarms disappear on the control panel. Press the anomaly reset button. Now you can see that the Bradford Allen disappeared on control panel. At the second method, we can test the Bradford Allen by deactivating the pressure switch of the furnace. As usual, start running the draft fan and ensure that the draft fan is in proper rotation. There is the furnace pressure switch. Close the air supply valve to the pressure switch from the furnace and open the vent bar, release the pressure along the pipe. After a few seconds, Bradford Allen activates on control panel. After carrying off the Bradford Allen, close the air vent bars and open the air supply valve to the pressure switch. Stop the Allen and press the abnormal reset button on control panel and ensure that the Allen disappears. As the final, let's carry out the Bradford Allen testing. At first, start running the incinerator and ensure that the draft fan is running. After then, switch on the main burner. The switch on or off of the igniter is an optional. Press the thread buttons on the overload relay of the burner motor. At the times, the burner motor will stop and Bradford Allen will activate on the control panel. At the same time, the midfire Allen also activates because we switch on the pilot burner of the incinerator. Press the reset button on the overload relay after carrying out the Allen testing. Press the abnormal reset buttons and ensure Allen disappears on control panel. Stop running the incinerator, switch off the main burner and the pilot igniter. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel.